I think AI is going to progress developments around the world. The Americans are doing it, the Chinese are doing it, I'm sure the Russians are doing it too. And we in Singapore, we have some researchers in this field, in SUTD as well as the other universities. It's the developments we will benefit from are what we can develop ourselves, but also what is happening in other countries in the world. And we learn from them and we apply them. If somebody develops a good AI to drive a driverless car, I don't need to invent my own, I will use that. What I need to be able to do is to make sure that my people in Singapore are able to make a living and to be able to contribute and add value even when AI exists. And it depends how fast it happens. I mean, if you look at driverless cars, for example, or driverless buses, it's completely possible. It takes time, but it will happen. If overnight we can have all our buses driverless, then I have several thousand bus drivers, or probably even more than that, who may be displaced and who will have to find new jobs. But if this happens over a period of time, over 10 years, 15 years, 20 years, then that is time for me, for the next generation, instead of becoming bus drivers, they can become something else. They can become bus engineers. They can become planners. They can become, people who are running the company. Mm-hmm. And that will enable us to displace and to adjust. I do not know how quickly AI will happen. If you are playing chess, you are playing against a computer, I think your chances are not so good, or go. If you are making a living as a doctor, I think that's a long time before AI will take away your job, although you will make use of AI to do your job better. Mm-hmm. I mean, to read, for example, if you are reading images from a biopsy, today a pathologist looks through the slides, slide by slide, scrutinizes a complicated microscopic image, and then she looks at this whole thing, says, one tiny spot there, let's examine that. Tremendous skill and concentration, but a task which could be automated. And that will make doesn't mean I no longer need a pathologist reading a slide, but it means a pathologist will now be able to do more and more reliably and advise the patients more accurately. So I think that it means we must master the skills. If you are in IT, then you should learn about the technology. If you are not in IT, you should learn how to make use of the technology. And if you are not so young anymore, but you should still keep up to date, well, at least be familiar, read about it so that you can use it as an ordinary person, as a lay person who is not intimidated by what's happening in the world.